We didn't see any impact. First of all, the air traffic grew by more than 6% last year. And second, we got 1,080 net orders, whilst we delivered only 635 aircraft. So the book-to-bill ratio is still well above one.
But you're not immune to a slowdown.
We are not immune, but we will be the last one affected by a drop of the growth.
With oil prices plunging, a lot more airlines are keeping their older gas-guzzling planes in the air. Is that having an effect on your order book?
No, it's not what we see. And anyway, a more efficient aircraft will always be more competitive, even with a low fuel price.
Airbus now has something like 64%, nearly two-thirds of the smaller single-aisle airplane market in Asia Pacific. But you've got two homegrown competitors emerging, Comac in China, Mitsubishi in Japan. How significant is that competition going to be?
We need to be very cautious about the competition because Airbus 45 years ago didn't exist. So the first lesson is that you have to remain humble and innovate faster than others. The very serious one for us is Comac, China, with the weight of China strategically behind them.
Let's talk about the A380, the super jumbo. Orders have been disappointing. In fact, they've now slowed to just a trickle. What's the future for the 380?
The market is a bit smaller than what we expected. However, last year we delivered 27 of these aircraft, and it was the first year in our A380 history that we achieved a break-even financially. I believe that this aircraft will progressively find its way for two reasons. If you fly as a passenger of the A380, you want to fly again with this aircraft because you have the highest level of comfort. This is smooth, this is quiet, you feel safe. And second, the market overall doubles in size every 15 years.
It's been described as 20 years ahead of its time, but if it's not selling, there's not much point building it.
Well, we have sold more than 300 aircraft, and Emirates is by far the biggest customer, but it's not limited to that.
So no discussions, though, to potentially end the production run of the 380?
No, I don't think so.
What about a 380 Neo? Is that a possibility?
The 380 Neo is on the drawing board. We don't believe the conditions are met to launch it, especially as it would bring additional fuel efficiency, but with the low level of fuel, the current 380 is extremely competitive.